That was a huge step from the session I just left, by the way. From an energy level standpoint.
We're waiting for the dance moves, Abby.
Everyone, I'm not the only one that's dancing at home by themselves right now. Oh yeah, Heidi.
I'd start dancing if I had time to get a drink.
Does everybody hear the sound? Microphone sounds really tinny, like hard to hear. I don't know whose microphone.
Who else has a request while we're waiting for our people to come in? I'm spinning the tune today.
I think that is great. Well, we can a couple of housekeeping things while everyone is coming in. There is a chat function. If you're chatting and it says everyone, it will go to everyone. Otherwise, you can direct any questions, comments, et cetera, to any of the speakers who have exhibitions that you're interested in. As we will get started in just 1 second.
Hey, Cynthia, this is Bud Wentz. Can you hear me okay?
Yep.
We can. Hi, Bud.
Oh, good. Thanks. Hi, how are you doing? I'll mute my mic now. Yeah, thanks.
I think everyone is collectively saying thank you for the slots. For our friends at Little Rays. It was definitely one of the bright moments of this whole conference.
Well, it's good to see Pittsburgh here.
Okay, and additionally, if you have any friends or colleagues that registered and cannot find their Zoom link, it is in the confirmation registration email. All right, what do you think, 10 ILE? Should we get this party started?
Woohoo!
Yeah,
do it. Awesome. Okay, well, thank you so much, everyone, for joining us today. When we did this for AAM way back months ago, we completely thought that this was going to be a one-time digital thing. I think everyone is shocked that we are still here in this same spot, but thankful that we're all able to at least get together digitally. So welcome, welcome, welcome. And I'm so glad to see everyone. So just kind of order of operations here as we get started. If you can stay muted unless you are up next to speak, please make sure that you are muted. There's a little button that should be probably on the bottom of your controls. And please utilize the chat. Everyone's been working really hard on finding homes for their exhibits and working on new exhibitions. So I'm sure folks are really excited to hear all of your accolades and also just to, you know, hear you say hi. So we will move through as many presentations as possible in the next hour and a half. Everyone has 2 minutes to speak. And after that, we are going to move into more of an informal mixer happy hour. So everyone will get their chance to connect and talk and hopefully, see each other. So next slide. All right, Heather?
Okay. Sorry. I just wanted to say welcome and thank you all for joining us. I wanted to introduce the 10 boards. So the next slide, please. So your board has been working really, really hard over the last, or since we last met at AAM. So AJ Gale from Lucy Creatives, say hi or wave. Debbie Donahue from Imagine Exhibitions. Shane McConnell from Little Ray's Nature Centers. Cynthia Brown from Museum X. Hi, Sarah Myers from the Children's Museum of Indianapolis. And I'm Heather Farnworth from the Ontario Science Center. Next slide.
Great, thanks, Heather. So just a short update. The 10 board has created a survey for host venues that assesses your interest and your need for incoming traveling exhibitions in an effort to evaluate the current state of the industry and assist with planning in the future. So if you are an organization that hosts traveling exhibitions, we are asking if you could please complete the survey. It takes less than 5 minutes. About your intent to host a traveling exhibition. It will be kept confidential. And if you produce traveling exhibitions, if you are inclined to send out this survey to your mailing list for people who have hosted in the past or hosting in the future so that we can get the survey far and wide to get the best picture about what's happening in our industry right now. And there is a link to the survey right here. I'll also put it in the chat. And we need all the surveys to be filled out by October 27th. Thanks. Next slide.
Well, something that comes through with great assistance from Imagine Exhibitions is this program, which is assisting those who have had problems with being furloughed or had their positions canceled. So just suggest that you take a look at museumexpert.org as a resource for the situation that we're so many of us are confronting today. Next. And Informal Learning Experiences, who has been running these forums for many, many years, really, really pleased to be partnering with TEN. As we say, it's the second time that we are doing this unexpectedly. We'll see what happens at AAM in the spring. But I would just like to mention that the two of us at the ILE, me as the leader of the consulting firm, and Colby Dorsey, who is our online guru, and as many of you have had contact with her, having to deal with our traveling exhibits database, as well as the organization of the forums in various configurations. So we're delighted to be half of the organization that's bringing this to ASTC today. Next.
And really quickly, before we jump into the start of our presentations, we do have a couple of polls. Just really quickly, what type of organization do you represent? Excellent. So mostly science centers here, which makes sense. All right. And if you belong to an organization, is your museum currently open to the public? All right, we're looking at about a 50% open rate. All right, and did you guys actually attend the virtual ASTC? And we'll chat a little bit more about that during the happy hour. Oh, wow. And about 50-50. So glad that you guys could join us. All right. And last but not least, is your organization planning on hosting a traveling exhibition in the next year? Awesome. Great stuff. So about 47% of you said yes. So hopefully we can find you some really great exhibitions to help fill those spots. All right, next slide. Kelly, do you want to kick this off?
Are you here, Kelly?
Okay, sorry. Did you get, is this the updated one with the ASTC slide? No. Okay, never mind. So I made a slide of ASTC logos. It was very cool. It's all right.
We'll show that in the happy hour.
Okay, perfect. Hi, everyone. This is Kelly with Minotaur, and I'm delighted to see you all as I click through across the top. And I truly wish we were together to celebrate this Minotaur's 30th ASTC. The ASTC conference stands out to me not only as a highlight of my year, but as an annual celebration of the finding of my people. It was Louisville, 1991, back when Aztec was so small, the entire conference took place in a single hotel. And one fateful night, 20 plus conference attendees, led by a large contingent from COSAI, snuck into the hotel ballroom after hours and partied in Ontario Science Center's maze that we'd set up for an event the following day. There could have been no better introduction. The conference buzzed the next morning with stories of late night hijinks within the corridors of what would become a new and versatile way to tell stories and engage people. So I'd like to give my heartfelt thanks to all of you for being a community that inspires me to this day to collaborate and create ever cooler exhibits and ways to engage. And I will raise a drink to you and with you at the happy hour to follow. Next slide, please. Speaking of collaborating, our new exhibit, Amazing Pollinators, seems to be a super spreader of collaboration. In addition to the four partners who helped us create it, we've recently joined forces with two more national organizations, Bee City USA and Bee City Canada. It turns out that cities that have already committed to pollinator conservation are fertile ground for this exhibit, which harnesses that local energy into a region-wide event centered around your institution. So we look forward to starting conversations between you and your local governments and conservation groups and driving real action to save pollinators. Next slide. I recently shared our partnership with Little Ray's Nature Centers, pairing our maze exhibits with their popular live animal exhibits. We are pleased to announce another world-class partner, Outhouse Exhibit Services, whose live butterfly experiences beautifully complement our exhibits. A picture of a vibrant butterfly house featured alongside Amazing Butterflies, Tropical Odyssey, or Amazing Pollinators. It's a proven blockbuster combination. Next slide. Mazes and brain games for smaller galleries. Enough said. Next slide. Near-term availability. We've got 10 great exhibits starting at $30,000. Your visitors and budget directors will thank you. And last slide, please. Please check out our awesome new website. It's got everything, COVID info, specs, even pricing. MinotaurMazes.com. Let us help you thrive.
Okay, thank you, Kelly. We now will move on to Debbie.
Happy anniversary, Minotaur. That's quite the accomplishment. Hi, everybody. I'm Debbie Donahue from Imagine Exhibitions, and we have over 30 traveling exhibitions, including exhibitions on drones, angry birds, steampunk, survival, plastinated human bodies, to mention a few. But today I'm going to speak to you specifically about drum roll. Next slide, please. As we all know, dinosaurs are a guaranteed attendance driver. All sets of our popular exhibition are backed by paleontological research by a professional paleontologist. They include fossils, casts, great content, and updated interactives for current times. Next slide, please. We have multiple sizes and sets of this show, which can go indoors or outdoors to meet every venue's budget and space. We've been working with our clients to figure out the best solutions to the challenges that they are facing. These exhibitions are flexible to meet your unique needs. Next slide, please. Nature Connects, made of Lego bricks, is proven to drive and boost attendance at host venues. All of Sean Kenny's exhibitions are a blend of art, science, and innovation in order to inspire visitors of all ages to think and create in new, more colorful ways. Nature Connects can go indoors or outdoors. Next slide, please. Also from Sean Kenny, we offer Animal Superpowers, which invites your guests inside the pages of a real-world superhero story by showcasing sculptures of creatures who have evolved to possess superpowers. Educational content of this exhibition explores the evolutionary, biological, and environmental reasons for these amazing adaptations. Next slide, please. We're extremely excited for our partners at SciTech to tell you about their newest exhibition later in today's program. So contact me, please, to learn more about our adapted floor plans, updated interactives, and most importantly, your unique needs and challenges,
so that we can help provide solutions. Thank you.
Okay, now we'll move on to Shane McConnell.
It's actually going to be Paul Goulet.
Thanks, Shane. I got it. I unmuted myself. Thanks, Mark. Thanks, Shane. I'm Paul Goulet. I'm the founder and CEO of Little Ways Nature Center. And we have eight different touring-themed exhibits that we travel. We're the ones with the sloth, everybody. So I'm glad everybody has enjoyed the sloth cam. I think it's going to be a permanent addition for us. But we do have eight exhibits, including Under the Canopy, Survival of the Slowest, which is our main exhibit that highlights the sloth, Wildlife Rescue, Frogs and Friends, Nature's Ninjas, and we have some really exciting new things that we have on the go. Next slide, please. We just opened a pilot program. It's something we've been working on for 2 years with the Museum of Science and Technology in Syracuse. And we're working on with this program with two other museums in North America right now to actually have in-house turnkey nature centers permanently within their museum. So if anyone is interested in having a nature center, maybe you have live animals already or looking to expand on that, bring live animals in, certainly. It is something that we are offering a fully turnkey solution with permanent and even rotating exhibits that are completely managed by our staff. So if anyone's interested in exploring permanently or semi-permanently expanding live animal collections or getting live animals, we are looking for partners right now across the US and Canada for this unique program. Next slide, please. Of course, with the changing times, we had some demand for outdoor exhibits. We are releasing a new exhibit called Giant Snakes of the World. There will be an indoor version of it as well, but we are going to have an outdoor version that is going to be ready for spring of 2021. Certainly COVID-19 has brought up a demand for this, but I think it could be a wonderful exhibit long after COVID-19 as well. Next slide, please. We do have, as I mentioned, eight exhibits. We do have availability starting as early. I think we have one exhibit available this winter. I should know that. And then we do have availability starting in summer and fall of 2021. We're very flexible with respect to spacing. Our exhibits will take up anywhere from 2,000 to 8,000 square feet, depending on what people are looking for. We actually have multiple versions of sizes of the majority of our visits. So they're not just for large museums, and certainly can be available very interactive or with hands-on elements removed. Next slide, please. As my dear friend Kelly touched on, we have a wonderful partnership as well with Minotaur Mazes. Kelly, super congrats, buddy. 30 years is absolutely incredible. It's amazing. But Kelly's team and ours have combined forces to make a more robust offering for museums, not necessarily bigger, but if someone's looking to have maybe a smaller section of live animals with Minotaur Mazes or looking to add mazes to our exhibit, their play space and our incredible live animal exhibits, I think, is just going to be a blockbuster combination. Next slide.
Paul, you muted yourself.
I was saying Shane put the slide with me with the bottle of wine in there as a joke, and he took it out. I'm like, no, you need to leave it there. If I was at the conference, I would probably look a little sloppier with two bottles of wine. So I miss you guys. I hope everybody has a wonderful conference. Thanks so much for putting this on, everybody.
Okay, we do want to hold to the 2 minutes. Is my dinger coming through? Do you hear it?
I did not, Mac, sorry.
No, Mac, if you can just hold it a little bit closer to your microphone. And just as an FYI, if you do exceed the 2 minutes, Sarah Myers has mute powers. So you've been warned.
Okay, Natalie Das, you're up.
Okay, I'll zoom through. Hi, everyone. I'm Natalie. You may remember our MindWorks exhibition opened last year at Aztec. Since then, we've made some changes, as we always do with a new exhibition. We tweak once we've had many visitors go through to ensure that the experience is the best one possible. We are also adjusting exhibits to meet COVID protocols. Next slide, please. The exhibition allows you to explore your own mind. We hope that after visiting, your guests will leave knowing something more about themselves and how they think and react to life, and possibly reflect on some of the things that makes them them. Our tour now starts May 2021. Next slide, please. So these are some of the topics that are covered in the exhibition through a variety of interactives, either alone or in a group. Some you're standing, some you're sitting, some you're crawling or twisting, some you're even lying down. One thing to note, we have treated the copy panels a little bit differently. There are only instructional panels at the exhibits, and then their more in-depth information on the mind is provided at four portals throughout the exhibition. Next slide, please. So the topics above come to life in these experiences and exhibits. One thing to note that I mentioned, the COVID changes, the VR experience will have monitors for now, and we'll bring back the goggles when we're able to. Next slide, please. So I love Neil Gaiman, and this quote really resonates with me. Memory is one of the topics covered, and I know that many are talking now about memory, and as all of our memories during this time is working just a little bit differently. Next slide, please. So we also, I wanted to take an opportunity to tell you that we take incoming exhibitions. We are exploring the idea of outdoor exhibitions starting in spring 2021. So let us know. Remember, this is Toronto spring 2021. So we need something for the weather. We're also looking at
2 minutes
exhibitions for summer 2022 and beyond. Please reach out to Heather Farnworth directly for that information, for with incoming information. Thank you.
Could you hear the dinger now?
Yep, heard the dinger.
Okay. Okay, then we'll move on to Sarah Myers.
Hi, everyone. I'm Sarah from the Children's Museum of Indianapolis. Next slide, please. I'm excited to open up our tour for our newest traveling exhibit, Barbie, You Can Be Anything, The Experience. Starting at age 5, girls stop believing that they can be anything. This is called the Dream Gap, and TCM is proud to be partnering with Mattel once again to close this gap. The exhibit welcomes visitors with the inspirational story of Barbie creator Ruth Handler. It showcases a variety of career dolls from the past 6 decades and highlights female role models who have broken boundaries. The core of the exhibit provides families a chance to explore over 15 careers through hands-on and touchscreen interactives, themed role-play environments, and photo opportunities. The exhibit opened in Indianapolis on August 1st. Since opening, it has doubled our attendance numbers and has had nothing but positive feedback from visitors and the media. The exhibit tour will start in spring of 22. It is 5,000 square feet and will rent for $165,000 for 3 months. Next slide, please. If you're looking for 21 exhibits to boost your attendance, we have some great opportunities as well. Both of our Lego-based exhibits are available in next year with deep discounts, especially Castle Builder for January of 21. With COVID, Lego-based exhibits are great because they include non-touch models for visitors to look at. Plus, we also provide enough bricks that you can do multiple cleaning rotations throughout the day. We have a very, very rare opening for Paw Patrol Adventure Play in the summer of 21. This is an opportunity that you don't want to miss. Paw Patrol broke every single attendance record in Indianapolis when it debuted in 2019. Our newly refurbished Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles exhibit and Doc McStuffins are also available in the fall as well. Next slide, please. Here is our full calendar of availability that you can check out once you receive the PDF version of this presentation. Please let me know if you have any interest in the available slots and even the held slots. And with that, I think I'm out of time. So I want to shut up and end my presentation. Thanks, guys.
Very good. Perfect timing. We'll now move on to Catherine Diaz.
Hey, everyone. I'm really delighted we got to be here together today. I'm Catherine Diaz, and I am the Business Development Manager at the Oregon Museum of Science and Industry. We have a full portfolio of traveling exhibits, and I'm going to tell you about 3 that are currently in development and will begin touring very soon. Next. Alegra Mente means happy brain in Spanish. This exhibit is a 1500 square foot exhibit. It's bilingual and bicultural, and it focuses on the science of brain development in young children and really hopes to provide simple everyday tips and tricks to support caregivers in building brain health in their children for a lifetime. Next, please. Snow, Tiny Crystals, Global Impact is a 2,500 square foot exhibit that focuses on the surprising science of snow and how climate change is impacting global snow cover and in turn our lives. Next slide, please. Designing Our Tomorrow is a 2,500 square foot exhibit as well. It's bilingual and bicultural. It features full body interactives, unfacilitated design challenges, unique artifacts, and invites visitors to explore sustainable engineering practices through the lens of biomimicry. Next slide, please. So in the next year, we have several exhibitions available. If you're interested in any of these exhibits or any of the other exhibits I mentioned or any of the exhibits in our portfolio, be in touch with me. I'm happy to chat about availability, details about the exhibits, pricing, COVID protocol. Just love to chat with you via any platform you're comfortable on. Okay, next slide. OMSI also hosts exhibits. We have a 13,000 square foot multi-level gallery. If you have an exhibit that you'd like us to consider, be in touch with me. I will pass info along to Russ Rupp, our VP of Marketing and Retail. So yeah, I'd love to hear from you about exhibits we have in our portfolio or any exhibits you'd like us to look at. Thanks a lot.
Okay, then moving quickly to Michelle Wright.
Yeah, hi. So next slide. I'm Michelle Wright, the Traveling Exhibit Sales Manager at the Minnesota Children's Museum. With almost 40 years of experience, Minnesota Children's Museum has the largest collection of traveling exhibits on the road in North America. Our exhibits provide organizations with highly immersive educational experiences that boost attendance, engage visitors, and spark learning. Slide. This spring, we have three wonderful exhibits available for rental with dynamic pricing. The Amazing Castle exhibit is inspired by history and fantasy with 8 themed areas that follow engaging storybook characters. Our popular Storyland, A Trip Through Childhood Favorites exhibit includes cherished children's books brought to life, including If You Give a Mouse a Cookie, Chicka Chicka Boom Boom, and more. In Thomas and Friends Explore the Rails, visitors climb aboard a large model of Thomas the Tank Engine, race trains, and work on engines. Slide.
What is that? I'm done.
We have our new exhibit, Wildcrats Ocean Adventure, available this summer. We are currently hosting Wildcrats right now in our museum and have been able to do a lot of fun updates, including the addition of a digital aquarium. In Run, Jump, Fly, Adventures in Action, it's an exciting exhibit that gets kids active and also is in interest of sponsors that support movement and healthcare. In Framed, Step into Art, visitors enter a world in which paintings leap off the canvas and children are invited inside to interact with the art. Slide. So we've joined forces with Aardman Studio, the Academy Award-winning filmmakers behind Chicken Run and many other popular movies, to develop Sheer Genius, which we will host at our museum this summer. Then we will split it into two exhibits, Wallace and Gromit, Get Cracking, and Shaun the Sheep, Flock This Way, to tour North America. Slide. So if you have any questions or if you would like to reach out about booking, you can contact me, Michelle Wright, at mwright@mcm.org or 651-225-6053. Thanks so much.
Very good. Okay, we'll move on to Rachel Mastromiano.
Hi, I'm Rachel Mastromarino, Children's Museum of Pittsburgh. And today I'm going to feature two exhibitions that have upcoming availability at discounted pricing, as well as share a sneak peek of some renderings from our newest traveling exhibition, Emotions at Play with Pixar's Inside Out. Next slide, please. So Very Eric Carle is available for spring or summer of 2021. And this play and learn exhibit features activities inspired by five of Eric Carle's classic books, including The Very Hungry Caterpillar. Very Eric Carle is a timeless property that spans generations, and you can contact me for special pricing on this exhibit. Next slide. We also have Rube Goldberg available for spring or summer of 2021. And this exhibit showcases Pulitzer Prize winning humorist and inventor Rube Goldberg's iconic contraptions, imaginative illustrations, and humorous storytelling. This exhibit can be paired with our Rube Goldberg Illustrated, which includes original artwork. So it's either a hands-on original artwork, separate, together, or both. And you can contact me for special pricing on this exhibit. Next slide, please. And then our newest exhibit, Emotions at Play with Pixar's Inside Out, premieres in Pittsburgh in January of 2021. And this exhibit will begin touring in fall of 2021. Spots are filling up. Next slide. This exhibit offers interactive experiences that help visitors learn about the important role emotions, memory, and imagination play in our everyday lives. Hands-on and digital experiences will focus on the five emotions featured in the film: joy, sadness, anger, disgust, and fear. And visitors learn to recognize emotions and explore ways that we express and manage our own emotions. This exhibit is created by the Children's Museum of Pittsburgh in partnership with Pixar Animation Studios. Next slide. So feel free to contact me, Rachel. You can use exhibits at pittsburghkids.org, and you can visit our website, pittsburghkidsdesign.org, to learn more about all of our exhibits. And hopefully we'll be able to talk soon. Thanks.
Okay, moving on, Matt Heenan.
Hi, everyone. I'm Matt Heenan from the American Museum of Natural History. Obviously, 2020 has been, you know, just insane, or whatever word you want to use. And the exhibition world is currently very different as well. So whether this is temporary or longer term, we've developed some new options to give you more flexibility. Next. I'm very excited to announce the first of these, a new collaboration with the award-winning photographer, Levon Biss. Levon combines thousands of photos to produce stunningly beautiful images, helping people enjoy and appreciate elements of nature that are normally invisible to the human eye. Next. Here you can see some of the images from the first exhibition that we're partnering on, Microsculpture, which is a fabulous exhibition about the world of insects. It's already been very successful in many countries and is super flexible with sizing and space requirements. It can be displayed indoors and outdoors, and it comes with an app and a great background video. We're working with Levon on a few other projects as well, and you'll be hearing more about these soon. Next. We've also extended our range of popular 2D graphic panel exhibitions. These beautiful exhibitions have all been developed from our research and collections, including our rare books collection at our library. Again, these are really flexible in terms of display options and can be indoor or outdoor. We've also added a subscription option for these exhibitions, giving you an opportunity to program a stream of new exhibition content in a really cost-effective way. Next. After being open for only 1 week before the shutdown, it's a huge relief to finally have our newest exhibition open again, The Nature of Color. This family-friendly exhibition reveals the many roles of color in the natural world, across human cultures and in our personal lives, and explores the science and production of color, how colors make us feel, and how plants and animals use color to help them survive and reproduce. It's going to be touring from fall of 21, and we're starting to take bookings now. Now, for those of you who can't come to New York, we're going to put together a virtual package so that you can still walk through the gallery and see what it's like. Next. We're working on lots of other projects as well, and we'd love to hear from you to tell you more. Please reach out anytime. And in the meantime, stay well, stay safe. Hopefully we'll see each other in person sometime. Thank you.
Okay, then we'll go on to Field Museum, Evelyn Kuchmak.
Hello, everyone. I'm Evelyn Kuchmak. It's a pleasure to speak with all of you today. Next. So we have several great exhibitions on our docket. We created a final opportunity to host the Machine Inside Biomechanics, an immersive 5,000 square foot exhibit that highlights wonders of engineering in the natural world. We are proud to share that we are fully waiving the rental fee for this slot, so it's an amazing deal. In a minute, I'll share more on Antarctic dinosaurs, which is available for an extended booking in summer 2021. The fleshed out version of our popular show, Sue the T-Rex Experience, premiered at the Science Center of Iowa and showcases the world's most famous dinosaur. It's available for spring 2022 and spring 2023 and beyond. Our newest show, Absalago Women and Warriors, is currently at the Field Museum and begins a limited 5-slot tour next fall. It's curated by a member of the Absalago community, featuring collections, material, and contemporary elements. Next slide. Antarctic Dinosaurs is currently at our final, the last of our partner venues, the Natural History Museum of Utah, and this isn't your typical dino show. It's about the journey of scientific discovery from the field to the lab. It highlights how scientists across the world work to understand how Antarctica transformed into the polar environment it is today. We feature objects from the early expeditions of Captain Robert Falcon Scott, as well as a collection of the very first fossils ever discovered in Antarctica. Next slide. In this replicated mountainside quarry, visitors get an up-close look at the arduous process of extracting dinosaur fossils from frozen rock with interactives that provide a sense of working in the lab and the field. Next slide. Visitors will also meet over 100 fossils, including Cryolophosaurus, the largest and most complete early Jurassic theropod in the world. Experiencing what life in Antarctica was like in the past sets visitors up to learn what life is like now for the animals that live there and the humans that work there. Next slide. We are really motivated to fill the summer 2021 slot for Antarctic Dinosaurs. Please contact me or Chris McGarity for more information. Thanks so much, and we look forward to working with you.
Okay, we'll move right on to Heather Birchall.
Hello, afternoon, everybody. I'm Heather from Virtual Science Center. So I think it's fair to say that we've all been feeling disconnected from reality these past few months, but how about from virtual reality? If you've ever played a game or traveled to a distant land from your armchair in virtual reality, you'll know it's one of the most immersive and powerful tools out there, and is having a moment right now as we look for distractions from actual reality. Next slide. 40,000 people came to see our exhibition, Reinventing Reality at Lawrence Hall of Science, and got to explore the magic of VR in creative, interactive, and engaging ways. Watching families come together was exhilarating and reflected our enormous efforts to create beautifully designed yet playful exhibits. Next slide. There are three components to our traveling show. 15 interactives explore just how VR works. Examples include guests feeling the peculiar sensation of having a virtual body or creating a live point cloud of their bodies. Next slide. As you can see here, our exhibits are designed to be collaborative so families and friends can explore together. Next slide. On the left here is one of 12 VR experience pods where guests can create artwork suspended in air or play a fast-paced music game. And on the right is one of our careers and creator stations where guests can be inspired by the potential of immersive tech by watching short documentaries from experts using VR to treat patients, design products, and so on. Next slide. To ensure that guests feel safe and comfortable for the interactives that require headsets, the exhibition will be retrofitted with 16 clean boxes. And you can see what that magic box looks like there. These UVC disinfecting units are appearing in VR gaming centers, museums, and hospitals, and they work rapidly. Two headsets could have been disinfected in the time it's taken me to do this presentation. Finally, Reinventing Reality is 5,000 square feet, is fully bilingual in English and Spanish. We have a special discount for summer 2021, and please get in touch about tour slots in 2022 or 2023. Thank you.
Okay, Mark Greenberg, here you are.
Hey, everybody. Greetings from San Antonio. Next. So Math Alive, math, our exhibit, which shows that math is all around us and reveals that math is part of so many things that kids love to do. We've added two new interactives, extreme weather forecasting and cybersecurity. We have two sets available in multiple languages. People have really enjoyed this exhibition. We hope we can come to your venue sometime soon. Next. Our Above and Beyond exhibition really speaks to the future of aviation and aerospace. It was done in collaboration with NASA and the Smithsonian. The exhibit starts with the basic principles of flight and moves to the future where you can take a ride to an elevator to space and capture space junk. This also is available in multiple languages with multiple sets. Next, please. So we are pleased to announce that Evergreen Exhibitions is partnering with the Australian Museum to tour three of their exhibitions. The Australian Museum, located in Sydney, is Australia's first public museum, known for its research, education, and vast collections. The first exhibition we're going to talk about is Spiders from Fear to Fascination. I don't know if you knew this, but there's evidence that spiders would have been on Earth actually predating the time of dinosaurs. They're incredible examples of biodiversity. There's a variety of shapes and sizes and other characteristics, including superpowers. The exhibit includes specimens, interactives, where you can determine whether web vibrations mean dinner or the presence of a potential predator. Augmented reality, yes, you get to hold a virtual spider. And even the mobile app that continue visitor engagement post-visit. So I think your visitors will leave this exhibit with a very different take on spiders. Next, please. Tyrannosaurs, meet the family. The exhibit focuses on the family of tyrannosaurs, presenting the latest research and discoveries pertaining to their evolution. The exhibit will overturn your preconceptions about these vicious predators. Of course, T-Rex is highlighted. The exhibit Scotty, discovered in Canada, is one of the largest T-Rexes ever discovered, but tyrannosaurs came in all shapes and sizes. The exhibit is a combination of real specimens, interactive experiences, and a couple cool augmented reality experiences. We also have doing the world tour debut in the summer or fall of 2022 of sharks. And who better than a scientific institution from Australia to examine this topic? What's really cool about this is a cool cultural understanding and cultural component where the museum is working with First Nations people to talk about their connections with these animals. Again, that world tour debut will be in summer of 2022. This is all our contact info. If the app is still working for Aztec and you're registered, please connect with us. Thanks.
Okay, Melissa.
Hi, everyone. I'm Melissa. I work at the Ronald Reagan Presidential Library and Museum out in Simi Valley, California. We're like 45 minutes north of Los Angeles, sort of in between Los Angeles and Santa Barbara. Next slide, please. And we host special exhibitions in our 11,000 square foot exhibition hall, which is split between two floors. The bottom floor has roll-up doors where the items roll right in. And on the top floor, we have a freight elevator that can take things up, as well as a roll-up door that can crane in large items right onto that second floor. Next slide, please. The next two slides just really show some of the exhibitions we've hosted, most of which have come from all of you. So thank you so much. Vatican Splendors from Mark, Pompeii, Egypt's Lost Cities. We also self-curate. We curated our own Titanic exhibition, which did really well for us. Next slide, please. Other exhibitions, we partnered with the Peterson Museum on Amazing Automobiles. We self-curated a baseball and football exhibition, and we partnered with Disney for D23 Presents. We are now looking for special exhibitions. In 2021, we are self-curating them all. We're self-curating an exhibition on FBI, and we're self-curating an exhibition on World War II. Next slide, please. In the past, all of the exhibitions we've brought in are big exhibitions, $1-3 million, where we bring in a lot of historical exhibitions with a lot of artifacts, as you could see from the previous two pages. We are going to have a hard time being able to afford those types of exhibitions going forward. We are still closed to the public. So if you have historical exhibitions with artifacts that don't cost $3 million, please, that's my email, reach out, and we'd love to talk to you. Thank you so much.
Very good. Perfect timing there. Okay, Melinda Malzioni.
Hey, thanks. I'm Melinda. I'm the director of traveling exhibitions at the Museum of Fine Arts in Boston, and I'm presenting today on an exhibition called, can I have the next slide, please? Ansel Adams in Our Time, which pulls from the MFA's vast collection and brings together crucial loans of contemporary photographs. The exhibition fills between 8,000 and 10,000 square feet and has unexpected availability in summer 21 or fall 21, potentially spring 21, but we're at spring 22. We're really hoping to get it in the 21 year due to a COVID-related cancellation. Next slide, please. The curatorial narrative looks both backward and forward in time. So it traces the iconic visual legacy of Ansel Adams, presenting some of his most celebrated black and white photographs alongside prints by 19th century government survey photographers who greatly influenced Adams, and works by more than 20 contemporary artists who were influenced by Adams, including work by Mark Klett, Trevor Paglen, Bin Don, Catherine Opie, and Abe Morrell. Next slide, please. These artists have been drawn to some of the same locations as Ansel Adams, but have also engaged with many themes central to Adams' legacy. So things like desert and wilderness, Native Americans in the Southwest, and broader issues, including things affecting the environment like logging, mining, development, urban sprawl, and critically fire and drought as pictured here. The New York Times called this exhibition Ansel Adams in a New Light, and my favorite was the review by Sebastian Smee in the Post, which was titled, "I used to think Ansel Adams photographs were boring. This exhibition changed that." It opened at the MFA last year. It's currently at the Crystal Bridges Museum of American Art in Bentonville, Arkansas, and then we'll travel to the Portland Art Museum in Oregon in January. Please reach out with any questions. And again, this is availability for summer 21 or fall 21. Thanks so much.
Okay, Blake Wignall.
Hi, everyone. Blake Wignall. It's great to see you all. Next slide, please. So Museums Partners provides turnkey exhibitions for museums. All the costs associated, inbound, outbound shipping, setup and set down, takedown is all part of that. We're currently, and we partner, all of our shows are developed in partnership with world-class institutions. Currently, we have four shows that are on tour now in North America, each of them have some available slots if there's interest. And then we're working on and launching four new shows that we're gonna start booking here this spring. And if you have information, I'm gonna share information on three of those exhibitions right now. Next slide. First of those shows is Marine Reptiles. It was developed in Germany. It's a Mesozoic Marine Reptiles exhibition. It's incredible. It has some really cool kind of full-scale models. It has world-class fossils that they've animated in interesting ways. And it also has, it's gonna have the world's, it's gonna have the largest traveling AI paleo aquarium, which is, it will hold you for a very long time. Next. The next exhibition we're highlighting is orcas. It's being developed by the Royal BC Museum in Canada and is currently in development, and they're gonna be opening it this spring. This is a natural and cultural history exhibition, so it's great indigenous stories combined with over 100 original artifacts from their collection. And it'll start touring this spring after it launches at the Royal BC. Next slide. The last show that I wanted to highlight is currently in development. We just started development of an Angkor exhibition in collaboration with the California Science Center. This will focus on science and history of the Angkor region, really dive into the science of the archaeology of the larger Angkor region, not just Angkor Wat. It will have a limited tour that we're gonna start booking. And it's gonna have one of a kind objects on loan from the Cambodian government, first time ever. Thank you. And if you have questions, next slide. My contact information is there. Please, we're doing virtual tours of exhibitions. If you're interested, contact me and we can share out more information. Thanks.
Okay, Carrie Reed.
Hi everyone, I'm Carrie from Flying Fish. I'm based in Minnesota. I'll start with a quick background on Flying Fish. We are creators and touring exhibition operators located around the globe from Australia to Canada and the US. We offer exhibition development, design, fabrication, and management services to museums and science centers and are now building exhibits from Melbourne, Australia. Quickly, I'd like to announce a few newly formed partnerships. My team and I just started working with the North Carolina Arboretum to tour Wicked Plants and Making Sense, and are supporting the international production of, you can stay here, it's okay, on the first slide, of two small children's exhibits developed by the Betty Brin Children's Museums and are custom produced by Flying Fish. Our newest partnership is one of the exhibitors here at Aztec, celebrating a timely product launch. Allow me to introduce you to FreeTouch, a software-only solution that enables anyone with a smartphone to remotely and safely interact with your science center's touchscreens. Next slide. Thanks. Now touring in North America and beyond, this exhibition was produced by the Australian National Maritime Museum in partnership with James Cameron and his foundation. Next slide, please. beautifully produced with blockbuster objects and immersive technology. I'm looking for hosts in North America starting next year, 21. Next slide, please. Production on Hockey has begun and we're now preparing for the premiere in April at Montreal Science Center. Montreal Science Center is our science partner on content and education. Next slide, please. The exhibition is full of science content, is very interactive, and includes key objects such as a full-size Zamboni. I'm looking for hosts March 2022 and on. Next slide. Get in touch with me or my colleagues at Flying Fish to lease an exhibition, to create an exhibition or experience, and or to travel an exhibition. We'd also be pleased to share free touch with you. Also, please email me if you have a vacant gallery in 2021. Thanks so much.
Okay, moving on to Troy Rainville.
Hi everyone, I'm coming to you live from my living room. And we decided we didn't have the money to store exhibits, so we're gonna do it at my house. Just kidding, this is live from our exhibit hall where we've opened the Science of Guinness World Records since September, finally after launching in March. Thanks Mac and Colby and doing this again for the second time this year, and to Cynthia and the Traveling Exhibit Network for hosting this event again. I can't believe it's been over 7 months. I don't think we would all guess that we'd be in this position and doing this again, but nonetheless, we appreciate the opportunity. And so, as I mentioned, we're extremely excited to announce that in September, we opened the Science of Guinness World Records for the second time. It's our newest traveling exhibit, and our visitors have loved it. They've loved it so much, in fact, that they keep coming back. I think it's because they're a little bit competitive like me, and I hope that at the end of their time with the exhibit that I'll have a Guinness World Record plaque of my own, if I can only figure out what I'm good at. So this 6,000 square foot exhibit is a partnership with our friends at Ripley Entertainment and Guinness World Records, and it's jam-packed with interactive experiences where your visitors can put themselves in the shoes of record holders and try their hand at their challenges, all while learning the science behind these amazing records. Sorry, next slide. I think I forgot to put in the slide. And while learning about the science behind these amazing records and how science is used to set them, it reminds us that anyone, anywhere can be a record breaker. Each tour slot will include an opportunity for an official adjudication event with a Guinness World Records adjudicator right at your venue. Record breaking has the power to unite communities, ignite movements, and motivate positive change. The experience of an official record attempt is one like no other. Now exclusively available to our sponsors of the Science Guinness World Records, we have an all-inclusive Guinness World Records consultancy package available. It includes a premium selection of our record-breaking products and services, and it's designed to help drive sponsorship and involve your local community partners and businesses to achieve their own Guinness World Records while driving some extra revenue to your venue. It includes record ideation and dedicated records, adjudication, and rights to the logo and trademark. We'd be happy to speak to you more about that. Next slide, please. One more. Science North has something for everyone. We have 10 traveling exhibits that range from 1,000 to 6,000 square feet. Next slide. And if you're interested in any of these exhibits, please contact us. We'd love to hear from you. We have lease spots still available for 2021, which I'm sure most of you do. We'd love to get them hosted. We're happy to work with you and make modifications as necessary to meet your COVID requirements. And next slide. And thanks again, everyone, from the bottom of my heart. We miss you, and I'd love to be at the conference and having fun and sharing those bottles of wine with Paul from Little Rays and Shane and the rest of you. So thank you again for your time, and I appreciate it. Look forward to hearing from you.
Okay, moving quickly to Jeff Wanamal.
Hi, everyone. Good afternoon, and it's great to see everyone again. And also hello to anyone new to this traveling exhibit world due to changes at your museums. As Max said, I'm Jeff Benham with the Museum of Science and Industry, Chicago. Amir May's Numbers in Nature continues to be well received on its North American tour despite COVID restrictions. The 6,000 to 8,000 square foot exhibition reveals and explains the mathematical patterns that are in the natural world, from the spirals of a sunflower seeds to the ridges of a majestic mountain range to the layout of the universe. Next, please. Through dozens of STEAM-based activities, including robust pre- and post-field trip materials, an immersive intro film and mathematical artifacts, a mirror maze will change the way your guests look at the world around them, and they'll realize patterns are virtually everywhere. Next, please. The centerpiece is nearly a 2,000 square foot giant mirror maze, a sea of triangle chambers that will make you feel like you've stepped inside a kaleidoscope. In addition to theatrical lighting and music, unexpected dead ends trigger intriguing questions and artifacts. And of course, it's the best setup for the super selfies. Next, please. The show is extremely affordable as many of us are experiencing budget reductions at just $55,000 per month plus inbound shipping. All the travel costs for the supervising staff are included in the rental. And we just completed a successful virtual remote deinstallation at the Frost Museum with guidance from the American in New York City. We've had great responses and we're already able to see that we have availability through spring 2021. We're in Denver during the summer of 2021 and we have openings starting in fall 2021 and beyond. Please reach out for additional terms and we're optimistic to see everyone at our permanent copy of A Mirror Maze at MSI during AAM in Chicago next May. Thank you.
Okay, good timing. And now move on to Lisa O'Keefe.
Hi, everyone. It's great to be here on behalf of Agency 808 to introduce you to Crayola Idea Works, the creativity exhibition. We're very excited to announce that in February of 2021, the Franklin Institute will launch the exhibition's five-year tour. For over 100 years, Crayola has been sparking imagination, innovating, and unleashing creativity, reminding us all that everyone is creative. Next, please. Through unique and engaging puzzle and game-like interactives, visitors will learn and practice creative problem-solving skills and then put those skills to test in solving real-life scientific challenges. Designed as a fully turnkey exhibition filled with energy, electricity, and excitement in colorful and dynamic environments, visitors' senses will be triggered and it appeals to people of all ages, the core demo of 6 to 12-year-olds and tweens. Next, please. In a customized visitor-driven journey, an RFID wristband through scanning guides the visitors in each of the areas, providing them checkpoints and tracking their creative strengths. Next, please. There are three key exhibition areas. First, the idea workshop, where wonder and creativity are ignited. Here, visitors hone in on their creative problem-solving skills. Next, please. The second is the Colorverse, a fantastical place where real science is rooted. Here, visitors are introduced to real-life challenges in three zones: on land, under the sea, and in space. Here, visitors are confronted in exploring and finding solutions. Next, please. And the third area is the grand finale, and here is where the visitors' creative strengths are finally revealed. As the visitors exit, they are encouraged to continue to make their mark on the world. Please reserve your host spot today. Time periods are filling up, and don't miss out. Please contact me. Thank you.
Okay, Heidi Pinchall.
Hi, everyone. So good to see you. Thank you so much, Mac and Colby. And thank you to TEN, especially AJ and Cynthia, who had put up with me a lot. I miss everyone so much. Robert, I'm missing your cocktails right about now so much and all my virtual hugs. You know? And what I am really missing is my communal place, the communal place that I have. And so that's why I'm so excited to bring to you today this new product, Luminous Terrain. It is an outdoor interactive experience designed for museums, science centers, and zoos. It is designed by the award-winning firms, Beaudry Interactive, Visual Terrain, and Bandit Lights. Next slide, please. Luminous Terrain is an opportunity for your museum to create their own communal space. Think of your site as a dynamic, illuminated canvas. Next slide, please. It's your guests that interact with these luminous rays of light. They're the ones that will change the story, alter the landscape, discover the games that are hidden throughout. It's their movements, both individual and as groups, that orchestrate this collaborative experience. Next slide, please. For the host, the advantages are it's COVID friendly, we are hands free, we are outdoor, it's turnkey, it's highly programmable. So on Monday, it can be for little kids' night out, on Wednesday, it could be for tweens. It's highly seasonable, you can do it towards the season. There's no docents that are needed, it's totally intuitive, maintenance free, it's been up for 5 years in all sorts of weather. So Minnesota, it can handle you, Ontario, we're waiting to get in there. It's customized to fit your site. The content is custom. It's either touring or permanent, and it can go indoors as well if you'd like. For the guest, the experience provides that communal place. It's family friendly. There's social distancing made fun. It's hands-free. And with all the different programming, you can come over and over again. We have many other products at Beaudry International, including some outdoor fun firefly experience and changing the constellations. Visit us at beinteractive.com. Thank you. Miss you.
Colin Della Catriz. Probably mispronounced that.
Thank you for the opportunity today. The Canadian Museum for Human Rights uses innovative storytelling to promote reflection and dialogue about the importance of human rights for all. Our traveling exhibitions range from our major shows of 4,000 to 5,000 square feet to scalable experiences ranging from 100 to 1,500 square feet. Next slide, please. Today, I'm introducing two exhibitions which are presently touring North America and Africa. Odotowa, Stories of Girls in War, traces the journey of two young girls from Uganda, Evelyn Amini and Grace Akan, who were abducted and held captive for years by the rebel group, the Lord's Resistance Army. After their ordeal, Evelyn and Grace discover the power of using their voices to help find healing and seek justice for themselves and other women who survived captivity. This exhibition was produced in partnership with the Conjugal Slavery and War Project, which runs out of York University in Toronto. Next. Mandela, Struggle for Freedom, looks at Nelson Mandela and the movement that formed around him. Unexpectedly, the tour schedule for fall 2021 and all of 2022 has opened up, and we're looking for further North American venues. In this exhibition, visitors follow Mandela into hiding after he is declared an outlaw, then experience a replica of the tiny prison cell that was his home for 18 years. They will share the bittersweet joy of Mandela's release from prison after 27 long years. And finally, learn more about South Africa's first democratic elections and Mandela's efforts to rebuild a nation shattered by racism and injustice. The exhibition includes an award-winning digital poster-making table where visitors can embrace the spirit of political mobilization by designing their own rally poster and then publish it online and in the gallery. Next. Since we opened in 2014, our museum has been a world leader and multiple award winner in accessible design, which informs all our exhibition development. All CMHR traveling exhibitions include accessible features such as descriptive audio, embedded sign language, and wheelchair accessible viewing heights and tables. Next. Our digital components are designed to immerse visitors in the stories they're exploring using technology ranging from interactive displays to 3D virtual reality. Next. We'd love to work with you to bring exhibitions from the Canadian Museum for Human Rights to your museum and audiences. Please contact us to inquire about it. Thank you.
Okay, moving to Jen Wallace.
Hello, thank you, Tan and Aili. I'm Jen Wallace from National Geographic. Nat Geo partnered with the Jane Goodall Institute to develop Becoming Jane, the Evolution of Dr. Jane Goodall, a legacy exhibition which covers the entire arc of her life from childhood to present day and her remarkable contributions to science and conservation. The exhibit opened last November at our museum in DC. Next, please. Thanks. The Nat Geo Museum was truly honored and thrilled as an overall award winner by AAM this summer for this large exhibition. It is rich with AV and multimedia, and it contains over 30 objects on loan, such as Jane's childhood toys, notes and books, and field objects such as her journals and chimp tools. Next slide. There's nice interactivity in many parts of the exhibit, though due to COVID, we have carefully reconstructed and rethought components brought near to a visitor's face, such as the use of AR binoculars. There's also a life-size hologram of Jane herself and a recreation of her research tent in Gombe. Next, please. The exhibit is capped off with a call to action urging visitors to take a conservation pledge. We have several venues committed to this show already, so please let me know if you have interest. Next, please. We have 19 exhibits. Most of these are photography exhibits.
So I wanted to mention that for any museum worldwide, we can send a curated photography show digitally, and you could produce to specs suitable for your space, indoors or outside. We could partner with you to host a guest lecture with a local Nat Geo photographer or a scientific explorer. Next, please. And lastly, for future planning, we're experimenting in virtual reality experiences, including Altspace VR and virtual field trips through our museum in DC. We're also co-hosting virtual events at our museum Facebook page. So please reach out to me and our team if you have more information And thank you so much for this opportunity to share.
Okay, thank you. Felicity Sylvester.
Hi, everybody. Nice to see you all this evening. Today I'm going to be presenting two exhibitions. This is Jurassic Nations Monsters of the Deep, which is a new turnkey exhibition in North America, and Wildlife Photographer of the Year. And this is to show you how we are reimagining this photography exhibition. In Jurassic Oceans, Monsters of the Deep, we take visitors beneath the waves to Jurassic seas to find marine animals from giant fish and fearsome predators to tiny organisms. Next slide, please. The exhibition tells the stories of the planet's Jurassic environment and of the marine creatures that were alive while dinosaurs roamed the land. Across seven sections of the exhibition, we meet over 90 specimens, including the impressive long-necked plesiosaur we can see here, and we understand how land animals evolved to live in the seas. A tale of the largest known Jurassic fish, Lidsixes, that's 10 feet high, that's the size of a high cube shipping container, will show us the scale of the creatures of that time. Next slide, please. The warm, shallow seas of the Jurassic come to life through the state-of-the-art CGI films, watery soundscapes, and atmospheric lighting. This accessible, educational, and fun experience is suitable for all audiences, particularly families. As part of the exhibition, we provide an educational workshop, activity sheet templates, and a film from NHM scientists, all designed to facilitate for children aged 6 to 11. The exhibition fits galleries between 7,000 to 11,000 square feet and is available from early 2021. Next slide, please. Now, quickly turning to Wildlife Photographer of the Year, this is one of our most popular and longest running displays in the museum's portfolio. This annual exhibition brings together the spectacular 100 competition-winning award-winning images of the natural world, taken by photographers who are young and old, amateur and professional from over 90 countries. This exhibition can now be shown in a brand new outdoor format, as a nice alternative to indoor exhibitions, and we're now taking bookings for 2021 and beyond. Next slide, please. Thank you very much for listening, and we'd love to work with you. Please reach out for any further information.
Okay, Myrna Ace.
Hi, good afternoon, everyone. My name's Myrna. I just wanna thank Ten and everyone involved in allowing us this opportunity. Traveling exhibits, as we know, provide unique opportunities to introduce your audience to new areas of interest and excitement. Miami Children's Museum currently partners with other children's museums and cultural institutions, as well as national organizations, to host traveling exhibits in our 2,500 square foot What's New Gallery exhibit. So we look forward to engaging our South Florida audience in subjects such as literacy, science, cultural history, careers, and environment. Additionally, Miami Children's Museum designed and fabricated its own traveling exhibits that toured different children's museums and cultural institutions throughout the country and internationally. Next slide, please. Thank you. The Wizard of Oz educational exhibit is the first ever licensed traveling exhibit based on the classic movie, created by the museum and licensed by Warner Brothers. This exhibit debuted in Miami and it's currently available in 2021. Next slide, please. Here we share some images of the Ruby Red Slippers replica, as well as images of Munchkin Land and a couple of other interactive spaces such as the Witch's Castle, Dorothy's Bike, just to name a few. Next slide, please. The Lion Guard exhibit, which debuted in Miami Children's Museum in 2018, has and will be touring until 2022. And this exhibit is licensed by Disney and features a lot of really great interactives. It's doing really well as it's been traveling, and it will be available next year as well as 2021. And then if we want to go to the next slide, please. Here we have some images of the Lion Guard exhibit, which is from the legacy of the Lion King. We have Rafiki, we have the Lion's Den. We have a picture of Kion, which is Simba's son and in his group of the new Lion Guard. We have a maze. What's great about this exhibit is it does have a lot of interactives for children of all ages and all abilities. I look forward to working with you all, so I'm excited. Next slide, please. For more information about our traveling exhibits and any potential savings that we can offer you all, please reach out to me via email, myrna@miamichildrensmuseum.org, or feel free to give me a call. Again, thank you so much for your time.
Hey, Amber Stevenson, staying in Minnesota.
I'm over here shivering. Oh, hi, Amber Stevenson from Minnesota, or I'm sorry, Science Museum of Minnesota. Really wonderful to see all of you. And I'd like to tell you about two of our new exhibits. If you go to the next slide, please. The first is Skin, Living Armor, Evolving Identity. It was created by the California Academy of Sciences, and we are partnering with them to modify it to travel. It will open in our gallery in January, and it will be available to tour in June of 2021. It's 4,000 to 5,000 square feet. It aims to inspire wonder and curiosity about this uniquely complex organ, illustrate the incredible adaptive properties of skin across all organisms, and spark dialogue and reflection about skin's role in shaping human culture and identity. Next slide, please. And today, you're hearing it first. We're announcing another new traveling exhibit, Nature All Around Us. This exhibit was created by the Natural History Museum of Utah, and we're modifying it to travel. It will open in our gallery in June, and then it will be available to tour starting in October of 2021. This exhibit's 4,000 to 5,000 square feet, and it challenges the notion that urban and natural environments are separate or at odds by showing that the many ways that they are linked and encouraging further curiosity and learning about planning, designing, and managing to nurture nature in our own communities. It's filled with immersive environments and hands-on interactives where visitors discover the rich ecosystems within familiar places, from their own backyard to Main Street. They'll learn how trees cool our neighborhoods, how streams carry stormwater away from our homes, and how spending time in nearby nature keeps us healthy. Next slide, please. We're also looking to sell our Math Moves exhibit. It's in excellent condition, and if you've had plans fall through and you need something that's really flexible to take in and out or leave as a permanent fixture in your gallery, this exhibit would be a wonderful option. I don't know if I heard the timer just go off, but we also yes. have some availabilities. Please see me for more details in our other tours.
Yes, you did hear it. Sorry. Amy, you're up.
Very good. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Amy Bornkamp, and after a rewarding 19-year career with Chicago's Field Museum, I'm fortunate to be speaking with you today as the Director of Sales and Booking with IMG. Next slide. IMG Exhibitions is part of Endeavor, who is a leader in sports, entertainment, and media. Our mission is to organize and produce the finest quality exhibitions and entertainment experiences that captivate, educate, and inspire audiences throughout the world. Next slide. Current exhibition offerings include Victoria the T-Rex. On display at the Arizona Science Center, the 66 million year old specimen is the largest real T-Rex skeleton touring the world. Consider booking Victoria today to join this limited tour. Bringing visitors face to face with past cultures and civilizations, Mummies of the World fascinates audiences while providing a science-focused, low-touch learning experience. Now hosted by the Carnegie Science Center, Mummies continues to generate strong numbers in the current COVID climate. Next slide. Pompeii the Exhibition travels back in time to 79 AD and immerses guests in everyday life before and the shocking moments after the eruption of Mount Vesuvius. Drawing on breathtaking examples of Italian cultural heritage, Pompeii educates while leaving visitors awestruck. King Tut, Treasures of the Golden Pharaoh, continues its global tour while setting attendance records. If you'd like to explore this rare opportunity, please contact us. In the current climate, IMG can offer our valued partners a no-risk financial model. We offer quality exhibitions while assuming all risk and committing substantial marketing dollars to drive your museum's attendance. Future projects include Stories of the FBI. this exhibition collaboration will tell the agency's story from inception to present day through rarely seen artifacts and glimpses behind the scenes of this storied institution. Next slide. For more details on IMG Exhibition Services or our Traveling Exhibitions portfolio, please reach out to me, Troy, or Jason today. Thank you.
Okay, moving on to Jamie Grandinetti.
Hi, everyone. I'm Jamie Grandinetti. I'm the Traveling Exhibitions Manager for the Art Bridges Foundation. I'd encourage you all to go to our website, artbridgesfoundation.org, to see all of the exhibitions that are available to book with us. We have 7 currently on our website, with several more to be published online in the next month or so. We support all of our exhibitions with funding to offset shared and local costs, participation fees, and programming. Typical funding levels range between 40 to 85% based on need. Next slide, please. I'd like to share 2 of the exhibitions that we have available to book. The first is In Conversation, Will Wilson. It's a fairly small show at under 1500 square feet, and it's available to travel beginning in winter 2021 for about 2 years. Next slide. Will Wilson uses historical photography techniques to explore representation and respond to Edward Curtis's photography. There's a wonderful app called Talking Tintypes that's included with the exhibition. The exhibition was organized by Crystal Bridges and includes artwork from the Art Bridges collection. Next slide. We also have a wonderful show to offer called Unnatural Selections, Wildlife and Contemporary Art, which is organized by the National Museum of Wildlife Art. It includes a very diverse checklist in both media and style, and it explores the relationship between humanity and the natural world. Thematic sections include identity, science, politics, and tradition. Next slide. This exhibition touches on current environmental concerns and climate change. It will begin traveling in summer 2022, and it needs about 3,000 square feet. Next slide. Please contact me with any questions about partnering with Art Bridges, whether taking an exhibition or joining us to tour an exhibition of your own. I look forward to continuing conversations. Thank you.
Okay, perfect timing. Carrie.
Hi, everyone. I'm Carrie from the Magic House. I'll actually have you go ahead to the next slide right away. So Magic House has over 40 years of exhibit design experience, and we've created about 10 traveling exhibits over our time. And I'm going to focus on 2 right now that are very STEM focused, although we have others kind of outside of that realm as well. But the first one up is our partnership with the Jim Henson Company and Splash and Bubble. So you might be familiar with this show. It's a children's TV show that airs on your local PBS station, and it focuses on ocean exploration. So if you want to go ahead to the next slide. We have a lot of different interactive experiences, all with the idea of understanding the importance of ocean and what we can do, even if you live in the middle of the country, not anywhere near an ocean, the things that you can do to make sure that you are helping us to protect our one big ocean. We have some availability starting as early as next year. This is one of our newest exhibits that we just opened last year, and because of COVID, it hasn't been very many places yet. So if you go to the next slide. The next exhibit is also a Jim Henson partnership. So if you have a gallery that's around 5,000 square feet, you might want to consider hosting both of them with some discounts available for that. But this exhibit is bringing the Dinosaur Train TV show to life, another popular TV show that airs on PBS. But our exhibits go a little bit deeper than just the characters on the TV show. We're going to be unearthing some basic concepts in life science, natural history, and paleontology. If you want to skip ahead to the next slide. Can see some of the other experiences that we have there where you're really going to be learning about dinosaurs in a very kid-friendly way, very interactive way. We have lots of tips that we've learned from our museum on COVID safety, and we're happy to make sure that that goes along with you as well. We have some availability still coming up into the near future. So if you want to go to the next slide, I think that's everything. So we look forward to hearing from you. If you're interested in exploring any of our opportunities, you can visit our website for more information, videos, photos, and we are looking at openings as well. Thanks so much.
Okay, very good. Lisa Fletcher.
Hi, everyone. It's fantastic to be here. So my name is Lisa, and I'm the Experience Manager at SciTech. We're a science center based in Perth, Australia. So today I'm really happy to be sharing our newest traveling exhibition with you, Earth Matters, Rethink the Future. Next slide, please. So the exhibition empowers visitors to understand the science behind some of the changes we're seeing in the natural world and experience how the smallest of actions can have a big impact on the world around you. So it's currently on the floor at SciTech, which is has been really amazing, and it has five distinct and engaging zones. So each of these zones takes you on a journey from understanding through to being inspired by innovations that will help us adapt our way of living for a more sustainable future. Next slide, please. So for the first zone is understand. So here you can discover changes over time and how different aspects are connected. So you can be a tree ring detective. You can explore changes in sea ice extent in the Arctic in a really engaging and interactive way. And in the backyard zone, this is a whole space dedicated to our youngest of visitors. So here there's a crawl through log. There's a really fun insect hotel, which acts a bit like a shape sorter with an activity station where you can make your own plans for an insect hotel and do material rubbings. Next slide, please. So the next zone is renew. So here you can experience our planet in new ways and immerse yourselves in incredible ecosystems. So we have a large three-dimensional coral reef, which comes to life with stunning colorful projections. And you can make different choices that impact the marine habitat in front of you. There's a large immersive and interactive experience. So you can see there's a field of wildflowers. As you walk across these, they actually will. Next slide, please. So in the final zone, reflection and reimagination, you can see innovative solutions and share your own ideas for the future. So if you're interested in finding out more, please contact Debbie Donahue at Imagine. Thanks a lot.
Okay, moving on to Sharon Smallwood. Sharon, are you with us? Sharon? Did anybody hear her?
Hello? Can you hear me now?
Yes, go quickly, please.
Okay, a little bit about us. We're in Ithaca, New York. We partner with the universities and museums there and other collaborators to develop our exhibits. We have very modular components, so there's very versatile social distancing floor plans available. We can help you out with space planning design. We have 11 exhibits priced under $30,000, and we're open to negotiating some of our openings in 2021. Next slide. We've partnered with Carnegie Science Center and started three new tours. They're all priced at $30,000. They're 2,000 to 2,500 square feet, one truck, very low storage footprint. We've got Bricksburg, which is a design build challenge, Leonardo's Lab, which explores the art of Leonardo da Vinci, and Gear Up, the Science of Bikes. Next slide. We also have our own tours that we've built and developed. These exhibits have gone through recent refurbishment and rebranding. We've got From Here to There, which is how things are transported and moved. And then also Sonic Sensation, which is discovering multi-sensory hearing. And then When the Earth Shakes is shaking up about with tsunamis and Earth's evolution. Next slide, please. We also have Toys, The Inside Story, Attack of the Bloodsuckers, and Tree Houses, which will all go through, two of the three will go through refurbishment this year during spring. So they'll be ready to start touring again in the summer. We have availability on all our, next slide, please. We have availability on all our exhibits throughout 2021 and into 2022. So if you're looking at either having a small exhibit at a good price point or perhaps working with us to combine and partner two of our smaller exhibits, we're look forward to hearing from you. Thank you.
Okay, Robert Aspinall.
I'm going to quickly just jump in here super quick. So we're running up on time and we want to make sure that we're honoring some of the folks that have supported ILE here for a number of years. And so for the folks that are down here as vendors, if you guys can just pop on and say hello, we'll make sure that you have some breakout time during the happy hour.
Okay, so Robert. Robert, I don't hear you. Robert, are you going to come on?
I don't think I see him on the list.
Yeah, he's here, but I go to Jeff Curley right now then.
All right. Great. So do we have 2 minutes or are we just saying hi, Cynthia?
Just saying hi, but we'll make sure you get some time in the happy hour.
Sounds good. Hi, everyone. Please check out our slide and get in touch with us with some of these new projects we have going on. Good to see everyone.
Okay, then we'll move on to Cheryl Murray.
Hello, everyone. Good to see you. On Keywords for Turnkey. Education, curriculum, STEAM learning, standards compliant field trips. If those words are key to you, call Turnkey.
Okay, John Shaw, are you on board and quick?
I'm here. Hi, Mac. Thanks, Cheryl. We can vouch for Cheryl. Museum EXP has worked with Turnkey on a couple projects recently. And if you have any projects for us, we'd love to talk to you more. So nice to see everyone.
Okay, David Whitemire.
Hey, I'm sorry that I can't be there with everybody in person. Just kidding. It would be great if we were in Pittsburgh together, but hopefully next year. Check out our portfolio at lucycreative.com when you've got some time to see some examples of our work, and also follow us on LinkedIn and Facebook to see what we're working on. Thanks, Mac.
Okay, then we'll move ahead to Bud Wentz.
Hey, everybody. I just wanted to show you something that may be applicable to many projects beyond those that use our Wentzscope microscopes, which you're all probably familiar with. People are afraid to touch things, and we have a focus knob. You've got to grab and turn it, so that could be a problem during the coronavirus era. So we provide a fluted piece that can go around the knob, so you can turn it with just a stick or your car keys or almost anything, and this may be applicable to other hands-on exhibits that people are working on. You can also see the image on a video screen, which is something that we developed a few years ago. Anyway, I just want to say hi. Hope you're all doing well. Take care.
Okay, well, thank you very much. Margaret Keough.
Hello, this is Margaret Keough. Hello.
Yes, you're here.
Okay, I just see your face. I'm with Mid-America Arts Alliance, and we are home to Exhibits USA and NEH on the Road. So we tour exhibitions across the United States using funds that we receive from the National Endowment for the Arts and the National Endowment for the Humanities at a low cost for the small to mid-sized venue. So check out our websites if you're interested.
Okay, then we'll go on to Shawana.
Just a quick question to clarify. Do I have 2 minutes or just here to say hello?
Go ahead. You have 2 minutes, Shawana. Okay. We're going to try to get through EDG and then we'll cut it over to happy hour. For those of you that are still on the wait list, we will distribute all of your slides, and I'm more than happy to set up breakout rooms with anyone who's interested in your exhibitions.
Thanks, Cynthia. Hi, everyone. I'm Shawana Lee with the Museum of Pop Culture, or MOPOP. We're in Seattle, Washington. I wanted to introduce an exhibition that we are starting to tour. It's Minecraft the Exhibition. With the partnership of Mojang and Microsoft, MOPOP was the first venue to premiere Minecraft. So we opened on October 19th, 2019. And since then we've seen an uptick in our youth tickets and family membership, as this truly brings in a multi-generational crowd. This new exhibition celebrates the online phenomenon. It looks at the game's impact on our culture and the world. This exhibition is geared towards players, but also non-players alike. So this kind of transports visitors into the Minecraft world. We wanted to make sure that this exhibition was very immersive and interactive, which, by the way, we have adjusted a lot of these for COVID safety. So we included game stations for beginners and pros, a punch a tree interactive, and films of epic Minecraft builds that show the amazing range of possibilities for creation in this game. Next slide, please. Again, we wanted to make this exhibition appealing to everyone, so even a non-player could grasp what the game was about and how do you catch the attention of people who know nothing about Minecraft? Photo ops. So we have 12 different statues, or in Minecraft, they're called mobs, where people can stand next to them for photo ops, like the Enderman here on the left-hand side of the slide. Next slide, please. While Minecraft was originally designed as just a game, it turns out that the game can also be made into a perfect tool for teachers of any subject. In 2016, Microsoft released Minecraft, the Education Edition, for educators to bring into the classroom and cover topics like programming, chemistry, humanities, and more. And it's more helpful than ever now that it can be brought into remote learning. So in our exhibit, we did have three stations as seen in the picture previously, but to be COVID compliant, we have now turned it into a two-game station, taking the middle one out for social distancing. And then next slide, please. So just reiterating that we have lots of cool photo opportunities and interactives. And as you can see in this slide here, there's the game stations, the crafting table, the nether is a biome of Minecraft. And so this exhibit requires 5,000 to 7,000 square feet. My information is down below. So if you're interested, I have more information on availability and rental terms, and I'd love to share that with you. Thank you.
Okay, then we'll wind up. Amy, are you on here with EDG or is it Carrie?
Carrie Noble O'Keefe. Thank you for squeezing us in. I'm representing Amy, in no relation to Lisa O'Keefe, but Amy's daughter. Just kidding on that. I am delighted to present you in the Aztec theme of the New Frontiers and COVID theme. We are in this together. Next slide, please. Our first two exhibitions are presented in partnership with our colleagues from the University of Chicago and the esteemed Fossil Lab led by world-renowned paleontologist Paul Sereno. The first exhibition is Giants, African Dinosaurs. This exhibition brings the bizarre world of African dinosaurs to life with original fossils and will sure to be a hit with impressive artifacts, including the world's only Mesozoic cow. Dinosaur exhibitions remain the number one attendance driver to museums worldwide, and these two exhibitions are no exception. Next slide, please. The second exhibition from Paul Sereno's Fossil Lab is Spinosaurus/Giants of the Cretaceous. This exhibition presents the largest predatory dinosaur ever discovered. It will intrigue visitors with real fossils, interactive displays, film footage of its excavation, and a unique 50-foot long swimming dinosaur skeleton. Next slide, please. Our final latest Aztec exhibition release is Digital Me, curated by the scientists and artists of Mattatec National Museum of Art and Science in Israel. This exhibition is most relevant exhibition to our lives today and common cultural topic. Have you ever seen the recent documentary, The Social Dilemma on Netflix? Crazy and scary, right? This is the premise and vision of the exhibition's curator, Amir Shore. Visitors will experience behind the scenes and up close what their digital footprint looks like and traces left behind from the use of computers and smartphone devices. The exhibition is in Minnesota and ready to be hosted by an Aztec institution as early as November 2020. Next slide, please. Are you a culture nut? Culture Nut Exchange is EDG's industrial distributor, bringing a global distribution platform to the cultural world. This is at all your fingertips with a new Culture Nut app. Buy and sell idle assets on Culture Nut. We thank our recent sellers on Culture Nut who are with us today, museum partners in Austria, Minnesota Children's Museum, Jewseum, Cincinnati, Terminal Station, and more. Let's help bring new revenues into our institutions. Next slide, please. EDG is happy to announce free, yes, free exhibition rentals now through May 2021. We need every institution to make room for exhibitions rather than placing them in storage. Lastly, if you are not, you are an EDG client, we are hosting an ever popular Aztec client appreciation happy hour today at 6:30 Eastern, 3:30 Pacific time. Call, text, or email me if you need a Zoom link. Thank you.
Well, thank you very much. This is a very compressed event today. We did, I think, a great job of getting as far as we did on this list. And golly, there's lots and lots of good stuff. And speaking for ILE, I appreciate your support of the programs that we have had in the past. I know many of the presenters here are supporters of the ILE Traveling Exhibitions Forum. And it's been a treat to work with DEN and combine our resources. Certainly I'm delighted to have them run the internet for me. But thank you very much. And DEN, your turn.
Thank you so much, Mac. I don't know if any of my other board members would like to jump in here, but we really appreciate your collaboration. And thank you so much to all of the presenters, as well as those of you who submitted slides, but we did not get to yet. So after this call, we will be sending out the recording as well as all of the slides. So I do encourage you to take the time to go through all of the slides, all of the links. There's a lot of really great stuff in there. And if you are able to join us, we're going to reconvene in about 5 minutes. And we're going to have a super fun mixer happy hour. It doesn't matter where you are in the world. It's 5 o'clock somewhere. Or you can bring your favorite NA drink. We would just love to have you. And for those of you that would love to have some breakout time, if you can send me a private message, I can set up private breakout rooms with certain folks if you'd like to get a little bit more information. So I'm happy to do that. And we will be back in about 5 minutes. And you can feel free to take yourself off mute if you'd like.
Don't know if this actually is unmuted or not, but I thought it just sound off. Steve Baker from Edmonton, Canada. Just thought I'd say hello to all. This has been a great little presentation. Thanks, Mac, for hosting this and the other group too. This has been pretty cool to see it this way, and kudos to you for staying on time. Well done. I'm super impressed. You didn't even have to use the mute button very much. Unfortunately, I've got to run because I've got to run out right away, but I'm going to join back in a little later on from a different site. And hey, Tom, congratulations on your top 50 piece there too. Pretty cool there, buddy.
Oh, thank you, Steve.
Okay. Chat soon, to see you all again soon.
I think we should raise a glass to Kelly and Minotaur, because 30 years, I mean, I haven't been around that long, I'm not 30 yet, but that's a long time. Congratulations, Kelly.
Congrats, Kelly.
Congrats, Kelly, and congrats, Tom, on your award.
Thank you.
I'm going to sign off too. Thank you all. Thank you, Matt. Thank you, Cynthia. It was a really interesting and informative venue.
Welcome, Sharon. Good to see you.
Good to see you too.
So Cynthia, how exactly do you have a happy hour with 200 people on a Zoom call? How's that work?
Very carefully. Thankfully, AzTech worked through some of the kinks yesterday. I don't know if you guys were on that one, but we have a couple of different breakout rooms. We weren't really sure how many people were going to be participating. So we have a plan, but as you know, with the times, we have a lot of contingency plans. So, and I see you have your bottle of wine. I am very jealous.
I'm ready.
Thanks.
Well, for some people, it's happy hour time. For some other people, it's getting ready for happy hour.
It's only 2:30 p.m. here, so we still have a few more hours of work.
Has that ever stopped you before, though?
I mean, the pro is that most people are from home still. So
that was happy hour in Minnesota.
Oh, hey, Amy.
Hey, guys.
Amy has some really great stuff listed on her Culture Nut site. So if you're looking for exhibits, make sure you check that out.
Yeah.
They have parts and pieces too. We bought some stuff from them at a great deal.
You're working out of the warehouse, or is that just a backdrop, John?
That's my office, maybe.
I love that warehouse.
That's one of the best things that happens with the Zoom calls, is looking past the people you're talking to and then asking very quietly and politely, what in the hell are you hanging on the wall there?
Is that what you're thinking, Mac?
All right, folks. Kelly, do you want to give us a little intro? Oh, you're muted, my dear.
Indeed, I am. As I was walking through the corridors of my AzTech memories, I thought it'd be fun to put together some photos. And so Cynthia thought it was a great idea and put out the call. So I put together this little slideshow of some AzTech memories from all of us or whoever responded.
Great stuff.
Kelly, you gonna sing Memories for all clients? Thank you.
graciousness and causes of success. May you have the confidence to always do your best. May you take no effort in your being generous, sharing what you can, nothing more, nothing less. May you know the meaning of the word happiness. May you always lead from the beating in your chest. May you be treated like an esteemed guest. May you get to rest, may you catch your breath. Oh, may the best of your todays be the worst of your tomorrows. Whoa. Oh, may the road less paved be the road that you follow. Whoa. Well, here's to the hearts that you're gonna break. Here's to the lives that you're gonna change. Here's to the infinite possible ways to love you. I want you to have it. Here's to the good times we're gonna have. You don't need money, you got a free pass. Here's to the fact that I'll be sad without you. You to have it all. Oh, I want you to have it all. I want you to have it all. I want you to have it all. May you be as fascinating as a slap bracelet. May you keep the chaos and the clutter off your desk. May you have unquestionable health and less stress. Having no possessions, no immeasurable wealth. May you get a gold star on your next test. May your educated guesses always be correct. And may you win prizes shining like diamonds. May you really own it each moment to the next. Oh, may the best of your todays be the worst of your tomorrows. Well, here's to the hearts that you're gonna break. Here's to the lives that you're gonna change. Here's to the infinite possible ways to love you. I want you to have it. Here's to the good times we're gonna have. You don't need money, you got a free pass. Here's to the fact that I'll be sad without you. I want you to have.
So good. Thank you so much, Kelly, for putting that together.
So good.
That was awesome. Thanks, Kelly. Cheers.
Oh, cheers, Kelly.
Love seeing you all.
Dinner shots.
I have to say, after this came through after we had already downloaded the presentation, but Kelly also went through and found all of the old Aztec logos.
Wow.
Nice. Does anybody remember that Gene?
From Aztec from Fort Worth. That was so great.
I think that's so clever. I don't recall that.
Yeah, I remember that one. I loved that one.
That's when we played Assassins, wasn't it? And Joe Imhoff killed me in the middle of the cattle.
Yes. Maze. Yes, I came across some Assassins files.
I remember that.
And we saw they might be giants there too.
That was amazing. Yeah. Actually, I have a live recording from that that I could pull up. Would you guys hear it if I played something?
I don't know that works, but
yeah, I think it works.
See.
Assassin was like the best networking game. I learned everybody's name because I thought they were going to kill me. So
that was great. Well. I guess we need to rebrand that and try it again sometime.
Yeah.
Can you guys hear this or no?
Yeah,
Cheryl,
a little bit.
Turn it up. Here, I'll turn it up. So this is They Might Be Giants live at Aztec.
Oh, nice. Wow.
Oh, I have that playlist.
Of course he does.
I've got a question for everybody. I'm new to Zoom. I'm trying to find the button on my screen where it gives me coffee.
We moved on from coffee.
The cocktail button is on the top right-hand side.
Oh, I already went and made my own, but I figured it was there. Yeah.
They won't yell.
It's right next to the martini button.
Oh, I didn't know that. Okay.
They had this taped to the floor at that show in Fort Worth.
Oh, seriously?
Yeah. I was just right by the stage, so I swiped it. I mean, it said Fort Worth, wasn't like they were going to use it again.
Yeah. I'd share with you, but if you could grab it through the screen.
Okay.
All right, guys, we're going to start with our first breakout room. So in just 1 second, you're going to have a pop-up and it's going to assign you randomly to a room. And I would love for you to discuss what was your favorite Aztec location. I think we all have one that kind of goes right to the top. And then what was your first Aztec? Kelly shared his, but I'm sure that the very first one is probably still seared in your memory. So we will have
our put those logos back up second. So I can remember.
Yeah, right. Yeah, please.
We'll remember for you, Sarah.
Natalie will remember for everyone.
Yeah, I want to be in Walter Hans's group with Barley.
Walter would appreciate that, as I'm sure Charlie will too. All right. Here we go.